Everybody, welcome back to Mitchell's Mind in 2. So today is my birthday, first off. Thanks guys for getting me up to 17 subscribers. Let's get to 20 here soon. And yeah, today is my birthday, so we did get some new things for mining. Like, we have an old style, like, gold buddy. Like, I think it's called a Job Hopper for a high banker. So, that'd be something. And, but it didn't come with a sluice box for some reason. So, what my dad and I are gonna do, we're gonna weld some aluminum together, make a sluice. Because it came with riffle trays and everything, but we'll show you what we got in the video tomorrow. But it's constantly raining. It's just a big pain in the neck. So, yes, we are going to be playing FS19. So, let's get to work on that. There we go. So, we're back on the Mega Ranch. So, we haven't given up on Big Bug Farms yet. But right now, I've been playing the Mega Ranch. Been doing some off-camera on Big Bug Farms, trying to get stuff sprayed and everything like that. That's nice. And, yeah, that's our thing. But, we gotta get this stuff done first. We got lots of things to still buy, and we have this cedar here that we have. This probably won't go on a big bud. I think I might use the quad track on this, or I think we'll just use the, just to get it out of the way real quick, I'll use this big bud 450 with the twins on her. Sounds good. Now what I should have done is I should have filmed like the farm, part of the farm where I run away from Big Bug Farms and I just get onto a different map where I have all sorts of other equipment that I like. I shift it down or something like that. And we start a new farm, basically. That's what I should have done, but yeah, maybe I'll do that in later videos. But not yet, nope. I'm gonna try to slip this thing back here. We got our carts. I think this is a disc drill. So there's a disc drill, and then there's something else, but I gotta get this thing completely straight as an arrow. That way we can back this thing up. Here we go, it's a little bit better. That's it right there. Perfect. This uses up quite a bit of horsepower, guys. This is like, what is it? It takes like 450 horsepower. Our Big Bug 450 here, it has 500 horsepower. But even though it's probably going to struggle in a way, but that's a good thing why we have these twins on here. But we also have the Case Quad Track 470, which is 525 horsepower, and plus it's probably gonna get more traction with the tracks on it. Let me go to Parker here. Doesn't that look sweet though? I have my Giants Island 2019 map like this, so I have one tractor that has one of my Big Bud 450s. Both of them have twins. One hauls this here, and then another one has a cultivator, I think. think it's that one right there. Man, that's pretty big. All these above right here, like this porch or something like that. I'm probably pronouncing these, I can't even pronounce that. The Flexi Coil. These are all mods beyond this. Flexi Coil is 24 meters wide. This is a good one right here. This is a Tiger 10LT. It's 10 meters, it uses 400 horsepower, and it looks really cool. Then we got a bunch of small ones, like, how big is that one? That's not too bad if we ever, it's 4 meters wide if we ever want to start a small farm. Also, you can change the color. John Deere. John Deere Yeller. JCB would probably look better on it. Yeah, not a big difference. Challenger. Garlic. Oh, that's not that great. Black. Kinda like the jet black. The jet black doesn't look too bad. Okay, enough dilly-dallying or whatever you want to call it. Let's get to work on this. So, what do we need next? Okay, we're going to need... Right, I have all my sprayer mods in here. So, yeah, these are the two that come in-game. This is an Amazon. It's a little bit smaller than this one. Like, this is 48 and a half meters. This one's 41 meters. But this one holds, like, twice the liquid. Yeah, there's quite a bit of difference between them. And this, so this is a mod here. In the mod hub on in-game. This one is part of the horse pack. That's the Challenger manure spreader thing. So, how big is this one? 36? So how much does it hold? 5,000. I think we'll get this Rubicon from Hardy. And I think we'll get this Torch. We'll hold off on the Amazon for now. I kind of like the Amazon. It looks nice. I remember using that model in FS13. Man, look at the size difference. This thing is small compared to that one. I think this one goes a lot faster. Yeah, it goes quite a bit faster, actually. So this may be our main sprayer, something like that. It's still good. It's still 36 meters. I'm wondering, is there like a shop or something we can put these things in? You can open this. Oh, that's perfect. Nice big area like this. all the doors are openable in here. Okay, this is the perfect place to set up our stuff. Get in here before anybody sees you. I actually watched like a documentary or something today on the Big Bud. Like the original Big Bud, it was like 900 horsepower, the original Big Bud 747. How he had to cover so many acres a day, he needed an 80-foot cultivator. He needed a massive tractor to go over the huge hills of Montana. And it ended up being that all the other tractors that could power it, they struggled to get up those hills. But not the Big Bud. It was 900 horsepower. I think the smallest model of the 747 is 760 horsepower. Then there's 900, and their biggest is 1100. Is it out here somewhere? Where are you? Well, that's nice. That's sweet looking. Okay. Actually, it doesn't go that much faster. This one goes 32 miles an hour. The horse that goes, 39, I believe. I think it's 39. Spurs actually go pretty fast in real life. Like on Walker Farms, he has the Big Brute that he made himself. It's that goes like 50 miles an hour or something like that. Looks kind of cool. Drivable manure spreader from made by Challenger, and plus you can change the color. Navy. Oh. That looks pretty sweet. There's Agco. Yeah. Yes, we bought it anyway. This is the Holmer, is what I call it. It could be Homer. But this is a mod. It's a Homer pack. And it's pretty cool. Like, one's a fertilizer spreader. This one can attach multiple things on its back, such as this auger wagon right here. It comes with a couple auger wagons. One's for like sugar beets and potatoes, and this one is for grains such as soybeans and wheat. This thing is a beast. I wonder which one would win between a pull-off, the Big Bud or this. I think I know the answer. It's probably the Big Bud, but Big Bud pretty much beats anything in the game. That just attaches right up on there. Boom! You got an auger wagon. I'm not real sure what that's doing, but Oh, you got Siege right there. Goes 26 miles an hour. I'll just put it in the shed along with everything else. We got our sprayers back here. Right here we got the Hardy. We got the horse. And here we have the Homer. I've actually wanted to try this thing out for a while. It's these hitches back here. It's got a 3-point on it. So we'll have to try something. Ooh, I got a good idea. The real truth. Is this thing really powerful enough to pull the Big Bud? The Big Bud's not really on there either. No, I have it hanging off. Gotta get the Big Bud back in alignment. I think we need singles on this map. Like, nice thing about this thing, it crawls over pretty much anything. There we go. We gotta get her up to full speed on this thing to be able to prove that it can pull the Big Bud. If we lose control, then it loses everything. That's not supposed to happen. Try to kick it off this way, move it this way. This is like the only trailer I could get on because it wouldn't let me hitch to my mod, but it let me hitch to the dolly though. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Freaking wiggle yourself off from there. You're staying with us. Bring it. There we go. No defense. That's what I'll do. I'll get her out here. I'll get her fully done, ready to go. We'll just back the Big Bud off. No use on hitching it. Just let it go. I'll just drive right up over her. I don't care. So we'll get this thing in a straight line out here, and then we'll try this out. Just wide enough to fit the Big Bud through. Try to get her up on there. We should be able to drive right up over this. Big Bud should be able to anyway. Or not, you know. Looks like we're unhitching it. which I don't like to do. Got it on there. Let's prove if this homework can prove herself, I guess. If she can reach full speeds on pulling this big bud, we'll keep it. Even though after I spend the money on it, on the little tool to go with it and everything, if I can get up to full speed pulling this thing, we'll keep it. Gotta back this thing up. Just pressure this thing backwards. Here it is, the big haul. Just gotta hook the homer up to, and then we set. We just took the big butt off. We extended the trailer out, and now it's ready to rumble. Okay, hook it up, and okay, here it is, the big hole. This decides whether we keep it or not. And the RPMs are roaring. I can hear it. There's the exhaust pipe on this thing. I want to see if there's a bunch of smoke. Oh, I think he'll do it, though. This big bud, I looked him up in real life. They weigh 130,000 pounds. They are massive. Oh, 23. 24. 25. 26, there we go. Probably throw our hazards on just in case. Yeah, we'll just drive this around a little bit. We haven't really explored the map though. Nice field of cotton there. We didn't have to yield. Oh my goodness, that's not good. We may have to rethink about keeping her. She struggled to get around that corner there. She started sliding sideways like right now. I'm struggling. I don't even know. Well, that'll be all for today, guys. Wish me a happy birthday in the comment section, and I'll see y'all hopefully tomorrow on a real mining video.